Thanks a lot for being here. It's my great honor and pleasure to be here. You are a professor at UC Berkeley and also the founder and CEO at Oasis Labs. I'm really excited to be here to kick off a really exciting week of the San Francisco Blockchain Week, where we focus on education, research, and development. So today, I will tell you about what we are building at Oasis on privacy-preserving smart contracts at scale. As we all know, data is a new oil. This valuable data can help us gain important insights and help us make better decisions. However, a lot of this data is also really sensitive, and handling this sensitive data can pose many challenges. For example, we continue to see really large-scale data breaches where attackers steal sensitive information about hundreds of millions of users at one go. And also, at the same time, a lot of the valuable data is being siloed due to the security and privacy concerns. And the siloed data really is causing a lot of lost value of data. And also, users are losing control of their data, as we have seen in the recent Cambridge Analytica incident. So to address many of these issues, at Oasis, we are designing and developing a new computing paradigm where we are building a privacy-first cloud computing on blockchain with a set of unique capabilities and properties. One, with a strong security and privacy protection, and two, with high performance that's designed to scale to diverse cloud-scale applications ranging from games to machine learning, and also with built-in support for privacy-preserving data analytics and machine learning. And also, we hope to achieve all this with decentralized trust without relying on any central party. So first, let me give you a motivating example. What kind of applications and capabilities this type of technology can help provide? So let's look at the application scenario of fraud detection. As banks give out loans and provide financial services, they need to detect fraud. And this is how typically it works in today's setting, where each bank uses its own data to develop fraud detection mechanisms. However, as we know, that in machine learning, in general, the more data we have and the more diverse data we have, the better the machine learning, the trained machine learning model can be. And hence, wouldn't it be nice if we can have a way to pull the data from the different banks together to build one fraud detection mechanism? And however, today we can't easily do this for a number of reasons. One, the data is really sensitive, and hence there's a lot of security and privacy concerns. And also there can be misaligned incentives. So using the technology developed at Oasis, we can provide a different approach where we can develop a fraud detection smart contract that runs the Oasis blockchain platform, where the smart contract can actually pull data from the different banks and then using this data to build one fraud detection model. And this way, it can help the different banks to achieve more accuracy and better results for fraud detection. However, of course, in order to achieve this, there are a number of challenges that we need to address. So first, again, the data is really sensitive. So as we train machine learning models over this data on compute workers, we need to have a way to protect the computation process from leaking sensitive information. And also, the computer results, the trained model, for example, can also leak sensitive information about the original input. Because after all, the computation results is computed from sensitive input to start with. And also, in order to support these type of applications, we really need to enable much greater scalability for these type of complex smart contracts. As everybody here knows that today, even for really simple transactions, like payment transactions, already today's blockchain platform cannot support high throughput and so on. So we really need to develop more scalable solutions. So this motivates us to develop the technology in the Oasis blockchain platform, where we are building a privacy-first cloud computing on blockchain. In order to support these capabilities, we develop a number of different component technologies, and when putting together, they can support this privacy-first cloud computing on blockchain. So first, at the platform layer, we build and enable confidentiality-preserving smart contract execution capability to protect the smart contract execution process from leaking sensitive information. And also, at the application layer, we enable privacy-preserving data analytics and machine learning to protect the computation output from leaking sensitive information. And also at the platform layer, we built in a new blockchain platform architecture and technology to enable scalable smart contract execution. So first, let me go through each one of the technology components in a little bit more detail. So first, let's look at confidentiality preserving smart contract execution. So today, for smart contract execution, users will send in their inputs as a request to the smart contract, and then the smart contract does the execution to transition from the old state to the new state. However, most of today's blockchain platform, the data and the smart contracts and the compute are all in public. But for many applications, such as in healthcare, financial services, and so on, the smart contracts really need to deal with the very sensitive data. And hence, we really need to develop technologies to enable what we call confidentiality-preserving smart contract execution, where essentially the data is being encrypted during to enable computation over encrypted data. So using this technology, the inputs to the smart contract request and also the states of the smart contracts will be in encrypted form. And the smart contracts will execute when given the encrypted inputs and then performs the state transition from the old state to the new state. And even though everything is encrypted, so the attacker from outside will not be able to see the data and the compute. But however, we still want to be able to provide a proof of correctness. We leverage different types of secure computation techniques to achieve this capability. The goal of secure computation is to protect the computation process from leaking sensitive information. And there are two main different types of approaches for secure computation. One is based on secure hardware. The advantage of this approach is that it can enable very high performance, usually very close to native performance overhead, and it can support for general purpose computation. The other type of approach is crypto-based techniques, including secure multi-party computation and so on. The challenge of this type of approach is that the performance overhead is very high, oftentimes orders of magnitude higher than native computation, and hence can only be used for limited use cases. In the Oasis platform, we combine these different techniques to enable developers and users to leverage these different types of techniques depending on the use cases and the security and privacy requirements. So let me just briefly talk a little bit more about secure hardware. So the goal of secure hardware is to use a hardware-based mechanism to provide a fully isolated execution environment, oftentimes called a trusted execution environment, T, or a secure enclave. When we run a smart contract inside the secure enclave, the outside, for example, the operating system, or other applications, or the attackers, they cannot modify what's running inside, and also cannot access what's running inside. And hence, the hardware helps provide integrity and confidentiality protection. And also, the hardware helps provide a hardware-based mechanism to enable what's called the remote attestation, to enable a remote verifier to remotely verify what has been running inside the secure enclave and also the initial state, and hence provide a proof of correctness for the execution. At Berkeley, and also in collaboration with other university researchers, we were the first one to demonstrate how we can combine secure hardware and the blockchain to enable confidentiality preserving smart contract execution. And also, then one question is, what type of secure hardware can we use? And how do we ensure that the secure hardware really achieves the security guarantees that we need? In order to address this issue, we have been doing a project called Keystone for open source secure enclave, which is a collaboration between Berkeley and MIT. So this is the first high-level description of how we enable confidentiality-preserving smart contract execution. Now let's briefly look at the second component technology, privacy-preserving data analytics and machine learning. So as we train machine learning models, one question is, do the machine learning models actually can remember sensitive information in the original training data set? And if yes, can attackers actually, by leveraging this, to be able to extract the sensitive information in the original training data set by just simply querying the model? So in our recent work in collaboration with the researchers from Google, we have demonstrated that, for example, as you train a deep neural networks-based language model, an attacker can actually, by just querying the language model, to be able to extract the critical numbers and the social security numbers that were originally included in the original training data set. And this is just one of many examples illustrating why, as we do data analytics and machine learning, we also need to be very careful with taking the right measure to protect users' privacy. There are different techniques we can leverage to enable the protection of data privacy. And one of the very powerful notion, a formal privacy definition, is called the differential privacy. And differential privacy essentially is a formal definition that helps to ensure that if a function is considered to be differentially private, that means that the attacker, from just looking at the computation output from a differentially private function, it will not be able to learn much information about individuals from the computation output. Even though differential privacy has been a very powerful notion, but there has been fairly little work in actually deploying it in the real world due to a number of challenges in deploying it in practice. In our recent work, we have developed various techniques and tools to enable automatic enforcement of differential privacy and make it really easy to use, even for non-experts, and make it very easy to deploy. And with collaboration with Uber, some of the technologies that we have developed have already been deployed at Uber. So by combining confidentiality-preserving smart contract execution and privacy-preserving data analytics and machine learning, we can enable privacy protection for a wide spectrum of different types of applications and smart contracts. So now let's briefly talk about scalability. We hear a lot of proposals and solutions for scalability. However, at Oasis, we have a particular opinion on scalability. So we view that scalability actually is much more complex than what people typically focus on. So most of the conversation and proposals today on scalability focuses on high transaction throughputs for simple transactions, such as payments. But however, as you have already seen, for the kind of applications that we want to enable, the smart contracts are much more complex. And hence, we need to provide scalability, not just for high transaction throughputs, for simple payment transactions. We actually need to enable scalability for much more complex smart contract execution. So the Oasis blockchain platform is uniquely designed to enable scalability for this type of complex smart contract execution. So when we look at scalability challenges for most of today's blockchain architectures, we see a number of issues. One of the main issues is that, so for a blockchain platform, if we look at it, what type of functionalities does it really provide? It needs to provide three main capabilities: consensus, how different parties reach agreement, and storage, for storing the data and contract state, and for compute, to do the smart contract execution. and the computation. Most of today's blockchain architecture actually bundles the three key functions together. So every node essentially needs to operate and conduct all the three functions together, and hence really creates a bottleneck where the different functions essentially are limited by the slowest part. Whereas in Oasis, we take a different approach. We call separating execution from consensus, where we decouple the three key functions into separate layers: consensus, storage, and compute layer. Where the consensus layer, the different parties agree on the state transitions, and the compute layer performs the execution of the transactions, and the storage layer will keep the storage. So this way, we can increase the compute capacity and the heavy workloads, and also the different compute committees can be used for different transaction types. And also, we use verifiable computing to guarantee strong security and integrity without extra redundant work. And this way, we can use verifiable computing to tie together the consensus layer, the storage layer, and the compute layer together to enable strong security and integrity, and also at the same time, achieve much greater scalability. And with this design, each layer essentially can scale independently and can be optimized independently. And also each layer is much easier to evolve and improve independently as well. And hence, the whole blockchain platform will be much easier to improve. So to summarize, at Oasis Labs, we are building the first privacy-preserving cloud computing platform on blockchain, where we provide strong security and privacy protection and scalability for complex smart contract execution. We have just launched the Oasis Labs recently, and it's really great to see the great excitement and support from the community. And also, we have launched our private testnets, and we have seen a huge amount of inbound interest from different developers and companies to apply to join our private testnets. And we have seen from the inbound interest and the developers that we have talked to, the wide spectrum of different use cases that people want to build on top of the Oasis blockchain platform. And here, let me just give you a couple examples. One is on building a new type of solution called credit score service on blockchain. So essentially, unlike today's credit score solutions, where we have individual entities like Equifax and so on that provide credit score services, instead, we can actually have a smart contract that's built on blockchain, where the smart contracts can take in data from different parties and use the data to train a credit score model, and then to provide the credit score as needed to different parties. And the capabilities provided by Oasis uniquely enables this solution. One, we support for complex smart contracts, including data analytics and machine learning. And with our privacy protection, such as differential privacy, it ensures the model does not leak sensitive information about individuals. And also, we provide protection for sensitive data during computation and storage. And also, the scalability solution for Oasis platform enables this type of application as well. And now, let me give you another example of a dApp that a developer is actually developing on top of the Oasis blockchain platform today, called Kara. It's a privacy-preserving tokenized data market for medical data. As we all know, most of the medical data is locked in data silos. And the goal of this application is to incentivize doctors and patients to share data and improve medical research. So with the application Kara, users or patients, they can upload their medical data to the Oasis blockchain platform, and the data will be stored in encrypted form. And the medical researcher can leverage the primitive and capability provided by the Oasis blockchain platform, the privacy-preserving smart contracts, to develop their smart contracts. In the smart contracts, the medical researcher can include code for training machine learning models and for serving machine learning models. And the smart contract can specify terms of use. For example, contributed data can only be used for training privacy-preserving machine learning models, cannot be used for anything else. And the smart contract can also specify how users will be compensated for contributing their data. In this case, if a user agrees to the terms of use, the user can then contribute his or her data to the smart contract. As the smart contract collects enough data, the smart contract can then start training machine learning models, and then the medical researcher can evaluate the effectiveness of the trained machine learning model. Using this approach, as you can see, we can significantly reduce the friction for medical researchers and pharmaceutical companies to gain access to data and to help them train machine learning models and develop better cures for diseases. These are just a few examples of the kind of applications that we see people want to build or people are building on our platform. Motivated by the great demands and the needs, and also motivated by the kind of new community and world that we can build together if we can really enable technologies like this. At Oasis, today we are announcing that we are launching an Oasis Startup Hub. The goal of the Startup Hub is to foster the community and to support startups who are innovating in this space. For the startups in our program, in the Oasis Startup Hub, we'll provide early access to our latest technology, and we'll provide technical guidance for privacy-preserving technologies. And we are really glad that a number of our investors have joined the Startup Hub to provide investor insights and guidance, including ACC Crypto, Excel, Binance, Pantera, Polychain. And also we'll offer exclusive events for the startups in the program. And please apply on the website to join the Startup Hub. So overall, at Oasis, we are building a privacy-first cloud computing platform on blockchain. So one of the many reasons that I decided to do this and that I decided to explore the blockchain area, of course, there's great impact, but also it's a really fun domain to work in. There's a lot of experimentations. And at Oasis, we are here developing really cutting-edge technologies to help the whole community to launch different experiments to see how we can really push forward the frontier to empower users, developers, to build this privacy-first applications and a new community, and it will help to achieve greater societal impact, and also to really help everyone to essentially gain, for example, privacy protection as fundamental human rights. There's a lot of challenges in this domain, and we really look forward to build the future together with our community. So please join our private testnet to build an app. Join the Oasis Startup Hub, and we're hiring. Thank you.